Well, we're halfway through. We are at the all-star break of college football, past the Red River rivalry. Let's take a fucking deep look into these conferences. We had our predictions and stuff, where we thought shit was going to happen before the season. We're over halfway through the season. Let's see what the fuck is going on, shall we? Let's dive into the ACC. Can you get more parity, Troy?
Not in the Atlantic, at least. I mean, it is a complete toss-up. Who knows who's going to win that side?
The perfect year for my Noles. They could be two losses to be right in the fucking mix. I mean, who wants the Atlantic Division? The Coastal is going to be a photo finish.
Looking like Georgia Tech or Miami at this point. We'll see what happens. Georgia Tech's over the beef of their schedule. That's with right. Only one loss. Miami, they've still got a tough game. They've still got a tough game with North Carolina. That's and they've right. got more chance for a letdown.
That's right. All right, so I don't know who to pick. Let's let play out on Raycom, bitches. All right, Big East. I still like my Panthers winning. I mean, Cincinnati, they definitely are the surprise team of this season, but they still have to go and play at Pitt at the end of the year.
Well, the biggest story is going to be Tony Pike, old rubber arm. If he can come back from this injury, we'll see. Only time will tell. But they do play at Pitt the last week of the season, but Pitt's coming off an either emotional win or an emotional loss against West Virginia. I think that plays a big factor.
Mm-hmm. Tony Pike is a goofy-looking motherfucker, though, isn't he? All right, let's jump into the Pac-10. Just head out west. Still love the Ducks of Oregon.
It's going to come down to Oregon, USC, Halloween night.
Trick or treat, bitches. We'll see what plays out.
Love to see USC with two conference losses.
Damn right. Fuck them! The Big Ten, I was this close. I mean, I was a fucking hobo's nutsack picking Iowa.
I hope I didn't talk you out of that because I didn't have Iowa at all.
The Jewel Hampton injury scared me, but Stansy, I mean, he's keeping a third manageable. They have a great defense. Ohio State, don't think we didn't see that fucking monumental upset that they got beat by what? The Purdue mixed drinks, wasn't it?
Yeah, well, you drop it and shoot it. Well, Ohio State still gets to play Iowa, so they could still jump right back in it. But Ohio State also plays at Penn State. I don't think they come out of that with a win.
Yeah, I know. They got Michigan, you know. They have a trifecta game coming up late. I think Ohio State blows it. I like the Hawkeyes to win the Big Ten. Big 12, still the North, it's a really shitty division up there. The North, I guess I still like Nebraska to pull it out. And Nebraska, their biggest game coming up is against Kansas.
Yeah, it looks like Nebraska, Kansas, the winner of that game maybe. But Kansas has a little bit tougher schedule than Nebraska the rest of the way, so I think Nebraska's going to win.
The South is where it's at. I mean, you've got just some powerhouse teams. Texas, they've got trick or treat coming up here.
Well, that's the thing, though. Even if Oklahoma State beats Texas, which probably isn't going to happen, if they beat them, they still got to go to Oklahoma, and they've still got Texas Tech on the schedule as well.
Texas Tech, I wish that's the team I like to see play Texas again. They've got a phenom in Sheffield down there. Still like Longhorns and Cornhuskers in the title game.
Sounds right.
SEC, goddamn, we knew what the fuck we were getting. We knew Georgia was going to be a mediocre team. And Florida and Alabama are the cream of the crop.
Well, I have no problem with that. I think Florida, Alabama, I think everybody sees that one coming down, you know, SEC champion. But the problem I have is all these announcers going ahead and saying, well, whoever wins this game is in the national championship. Yeah. I mean, we're only halfway through. Let it play its way out. You never know.
Exactly. What if both teams have a one loss going into the title game? You don't know what's going to happen.
Not likely, but it could happen.
Let's look at our BCS busters. I had the damn Horny Toads. And you had the Broncos. Mm-hmm. Both our teams are right in the mix. Boise State's actually above TCU, but TCU, they still have some meaningful games. And this coming weekend, they have to go play at BYU, and they have Utah coming up. Two ranked teams they still have on their schedule.
Definitely a tougher schedule for TCU. That's the thing. If they go undefeated, will they jump Boise? I mean, will there even be a spot available for someone to get in? Who knows?
We shall see. That's why we play the fucking game. All right, getting a little bit talky here, but hey, we're going to tell you what the fuck's going to happen in the second season. What are you looking for in the second part of this season? What excites you coming up?
Well, I definitely say the Heels. You know, I want them to turn it around. If nothing else, shake up the damn mix in the ACC race.
Just be a fucking wrench in there.
I'd love it, you know, and I think we'll have some great bowl matchups at the end of the season. I don't want to skip too far ahead, but I think there's a lot of teams, you know, going to have a couple more losses maybe than usual, some teams doing a little better than usual. I think we're going to see some unique matchups.
Today, the first BCS standings are coming out, and I cannot wait to the end of the season when they have the clusterfuck that is the BCS. This is the year where the BCS fucking shits out a fucking pile of fucking BCS bullshit.
But the Titanic can't sink.
It's going down, my friend. We're going to have a lot of teams sitting there fucking on the outside looking in. Should be fun to watch. We'll be watching. I know you'll be watching. And I know you'll be keeping it third and manageable. Oh, wow. Great show, Troy. Love watching you work. Very, very powerful insight, man.
I know. Can we do something about these fucking lights? God, hey, yeah, you, come here. Come here. Cut that shit off. Had to be a fucking cunt doing something with those lights. God damn.
Vic and Troy. The two greatest friends in the history of friendship. Knew their teams, Florida State and North Carolina. We're about to play each other. Thursday night at Keaton Stadium. Neither one wanted to talk about it. But the date was looming. The date was set. A date that would change their friendship forever.
Yeah, bitch, you keep talking that shit, you ain't never going to Chapel Hill. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, that's right. Have a good one, bud. Ah, yes. Vicky V. Heading home.
You had to fucking do it, huh? You think I'm-